please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 please don't take him just because you can. Your beauty is beyond compare with flaming locks of all.
Okay, everybody, good morning. It's a miserable morning in Cork. I just collected Dolly up in Knocknaheeny, but I'm delighted to welcome you all, really, to the Imagination Library, Dolly Parton's Imagination Library, Cork, taking place online today due to the restrictions. Just to give you a quick spiel, it's Young Knocknaheeny Area-based Childhood Programme together with the Cork Interagency Working Group and funding partners. We're launching the Dolly Parton's Imagination Library today, and it will take place online. I'm going to be your MC for the hour. We're going to be joined in a moment by speakers Catherine Harford, who's the Programme Manager of Young Knocknaheeny, and Marion Gilhooly as well, the Executive Director of the Dollywood Foundation in the UK, and Grace Walsh here, the Senior Oral Language Development Officer, Speech and Language Therapist of Young Knocknaheeny. We've got video messages of support from all sorts of people. Dolly herself is going to be doing a little introduction in a second. And I just want to remind you that the chat is open. Feel free to ask the panelists any questions. Tracy Holt is going to be monitoring the chat here, so just feel free. We're going to have a quick introductory video now, a word from Dolly, and then we're going to chat to Catherine in a few moments. So welcome, everybody. Make yourselves at home. You probably are at home like me. And yes, the Dolly Parton's Imagination Library, Cork. Let's have a word from Dolly.
Hi, everybody. This is Dolly. Before he passed away, my daddy told me that the Imagination Library probably was the most important thing I'd ever done. Now, I can't tell you how much that meant to me because I created the Imagination Library as a tribute to my daddy. He was the smartest man I've ever known, but I knew in my heart his inability to read probably kept him from seeing all his dreams come true. Inspiring kids to love, inspire the children in my home county. But here we are today with a worldwide program that gives a book a month to over 1 million children. Of course, I have not done this alone. The real heroes of our story was the thousands of local organizations who have embraced my dream and made it their own. They raise millions of dollars each year and wake up every day with a passion to make sure that their kids have every opportunity to succeed. It's been quite a journey, but we have so much more left to do. Now, I'd love for your community to join our family, so please take the time to explore our website. Let's share this dream that all children should grow up in a home full of books. The first step is always the hardest, but you will never know unless you try.
Well, thank you, Dolly, and I hope you enjoyed the trip from Knocknaheeny to Ballinlough this morning in the rain. It was dicey, but we made it in the end. We're going to have more from Dolly later, but I'm going to, without further ado, really, introduce Catherine Harford, who's the Programme Manager of Young Knocknaheeny. She's going to be providing a welcome from the lead agency and the Cork affiliate for the Imagination Library.
Thank you, Stevie. Thank you very much. So why does Dolly Parton, I suppose, inspire us? From a very young age, Dolly Parton sang, performed, and wrote songs. She's an icon and an inspiration to dream big, to shine, and be whoever you want to be. You've probably noticed, like me, that the songs she writes and the way she sings them, they have a narrative and an expression. She uses words to express herself. This is what we want for all our children, to be able to express themselves, to be whoever they want to be. Words, voice, and expression, so that all children can take their place in this world and thrive. Our President of Ireland, Michael D. Higgins, recently said it was his wish for Ireland's children that they would all have access to reading and access to musical instruments, possibly to be able to swim. That could be possible today with the rain outside. We told him about what we were doing here, and he was greatly interested to hear of this valuable initiative and would like to thank everyone for their commitment to nurturing in our children and young people a love of reading. In Young Knocknaheeny, we are supporting children's relationships, their development, their well-being and learning from the time they arrive in this world. We promote the use of books in young children's lives. I saw the launch of Dolly Parton's Imagination Library in Tallaght by our colleagues in CDI and decided there and then I had to bring it to Cork to complement our work. I want to thank Marion Quinn and Emma Riley for that inspiration, insight and support. This is the most comprehensive book giving scheme I have seen. One book a month, posted to a child, personalised to them to build their own imagination library. And it's focused on the 0 to 5 age group when we know that the brain is growing at an enormous rate. There is so much potential to be tapped into. I knew this was bigger than the Young Knocknaheeny programme. And I went to talk to people about bringing it to Cork and beyond. As of today, even during this pandemic, we are able to gift books into the hands and imaginations of nearly 3,000 children in Cork City and County. I would like to see every child in Cork City and County be eligible for this book scheme. And I invite people, investors in our children's futures, and colleagues to join us in this vision. Some have already joined us, and the response has been incredible and overwhelmingly positive. The Interagency Working Group from Cork City and County have taken over to realise this vision, very ably and inspirationally led by my colleague Grace Walsh, who you'll hear from later. The partners so far, and you're welcome to join us, are Young Knocknaheeny Area-Based Childhood Programme, Cork Healthy Cities, HSC Speech and Language Department, Cork City Council, Cork City Partnership, Cork City Childcare, Cork Education and Training Board, Cork Learning Neighbourhoods, East Cork Traveller Project, Carrick Tool Family Resource Centre, the HSC Community Work Department and other departments, Tusla, SIPSI Cork, HSC Public Health Nursing, Cork City Library, Children's Services and Wallaroo Play School. Organisations in this group themselves went looking for funding themselves. They worked incredibly hard. And thanks to Cork City Council SEEK funding, we got our initial funding, which helped leverage further support from SIPSI and Cork Healthy Cities, the HSE Cork City Partnership, the Learning Neighbourhoods Initiative. And I suppose we're very grateful as well for the support of Barry's Tea, St Vincent de Paul, Tour Housing, the Rotary Club of Cork, and of course sponsorship from OnPost for delivery of those books to children's homes. We also had the assistance from the late John Kennedy with Cork City FC joining us in supporting the engagement with families. Today we have Stevie G with us to thank, and Marion Galuli, Executive Director of the Dollywood Foundation UK. And thank you to those special messages of support that you'll hear from today that I don't want to give away at this point, but thank you. And to the over 250 people that registered for this launch event, especially to the children and parents and communities who have joined us today, a very special welcome and thank you. It's a real privilege, a complete privilege to do this work and to help nurture children's lives and support them in their communities that they live in. And I just want to thank everybody who've been involved. So thank you. Back to you, Steve.
Thanks a million, Catherine. And that was brilliant. It's amazing the amount of work that has gone into this, just listing it out there and all of the people involved. It's absolutely brilliant to be a part of it. We will have a Q&A later, as I mentioned, with Catherine, Marion, who I'm going to introduce in a moment, and also Grace. We have got brilliant messages of support as well, none more so than from Dolly, but there's a couple of Cork people who are going to be giving you messages of support very shortly as well. The chat is open, drop your messages in. Without further ado, I'm going to introduce Marion. Marion Galuli, Executive Director of the Dollywood Foundation UK, who will present the background to the Imagination Library, how it's developed over the years. She's also going to mention a little bit about the documentary, The Library That Dolly Built, which is going to be premiering via Facebook in the UK and Ireland on the 10th of December. So next up, Marion.
Thanks very much, Stevie. Thanks for that introduction. I'm absolutely delighted to be here this morning on this webinar. And I'm about to do a technical feat. I'm going to share my screen with you because I've got some slides to show you. So bear with me while I get that started. And hopefully you can see the screen now. No, you can't see the screen yet, but hopefully you can see the screen now. Just a recap, Catherine's already described the Imagination Library programme, that children receive a book every single month posted to them at their home address. And it means that for a child who's enrolled in the programme from birth, they will amass a collection of up to 60 carefully chosen books that are theirs to keep and to enjoy over and over again and share with family members and friends for as long as they want to. It's just the most amazing programme and I'm incredibly proud to be part of it. In terms of the history of the programme, you may know that Dolly was the fourth of 12 children. She grew up in rural Tennessee and her family really didn't have very much in the way of material things. But Dolly was always a dreamer. She always dreamed of what she might do in her life and she had dreams for others too. And as Dolly mentioned in that video clip at the beginning, sadly, her own father never learned to read and she feels that this probably prevented him from fulfilling all of his dreams. So the Imagination Library really was really inspired by her wish to honour her father and also her desire to give back to the community where she grew up. She's very passionate about her home county of Sevier County in Tennessee. And Dolly always says you can never get enough books into the hands of enough children. And that philosophy underpins the story of the Imagination Library so far. We count a lot of books, as you'll be able to tell from my presentation as we go on. So I'm going to walk you through the Imagination Library from its origins in 1995, when the PlayStation was a new thing, right through to the present day. And Dolly started the programme in, as I've said, her home county, Sevier County in Tennessee. And that year, nearly 2,000 books were given to local children. The Sevier County programme was so popular that it grew quickly, and by 2000, replication of the programme was underway. Children in 11 states across the USA received books that year, and that brought the total count to nearly 50,000 books. As you'll see, that total is going up and up and up. Just 4 years later, the governor of Tennessee, Phil Bredesen, pledged to provide Dolly Parton's Imagination Library to every child under the age of five across the entire state. A whole state guaranteed that every child within its borders would have access to quality books and the joy that they inspire. And now we actually have five statewide programs in the United States. So any child living in one of those five states is eligible to be enrolled in the Imagination Library, which is just incredible. And also an incredible statistic is that now every state in the United States of America has at least one Dolly Parton's Imagination Library program. So in 2004, to take you back to our timeline, some new partnerships were formed. As the program was growing rapidly, 2005 this was. As the programme was growing rapidly, an expert committee was collated so that there was a guarantee that the best expertise available was involved in selecting the books for the programme. And to ensure the quality of the books, a partnership was developed with Penguin USA, which is now Penguin Random House. And this was the first step towards transitioning the programme to an international programme. Chair of the committee, Jinx Watson, said, "In all my years as an educator, this is the most thoughtful and child-centred programme I have known," which is an incredible thing to think about from an expert in education. 2007 was a special year in that Dolly visited the UK to launch the UK programme. The first programme was in Rotherham, and that year saw the total number of books gifted to reach nearly 4.5 million. So you can see the growth has really increased in pace over the years. And since then, the pace of growth has continued to increase. 2018 was an incredibly significant year in that the milestone of gifting the 100 millionth book was achieved. And Dolly was presented with an award by the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C. And she actually presented the library with a copy of her book, The Coat of Many Colours, that is now in the Library of Congress to celebrate that milestone having been reached. It was an immensely proud and emotional day for Dolly, and she felt she'd really earned the title of the Book Lady, which is how she's referred to by many children in the United States. That year, I think, was also the year that Marion Quinn, chief executive of CDI in Tala in Dublin, attended a conference and heard about some of the work that was being done in the UK, actually in Nottingham, with the Imagination Library. And she decided she was going to bring the Imagination Library to Ireland. And the very next year, she did just that. The programme in Dublin was launched on St Valentine's Day, the 14th of February 2019, with a fantastic event in the local library that involved many, many members of the community and also parents with their children. And together, by the end of this year, we will have gifted 91,000 books since then to over 5,000 children living in Tala. And as Catherine said, that launch event really inspired her to bring the Imagination Library to Cork. And while 2020 has been probably the most unusual year for all sorts of reasons, we won't forget this year in a hurry, because it's the year that Dolly Parton's Imagination Library comes to Cork. And also, we're celebrating 25 years since the beginning of the Imagination Library. And incredibly, next month, we'll pass the grand total of 150 million books gifted since the inception of the programme in 1995. To put it another way, over 1.7 million children receive a book every month across five countries. It took 23 years to give the first 100 million books, and just 2 years to give an additional 50 million books to these children. And these numbers really are about the books. The books themselves are central to the success of the programme. These photos show some of the members of the book selection committee that selects the books for the UK and Ireland programmes. They're experts in early childhood development and children's literature, and they take great care to select a broad range of high quality, age appropriate books. The book list is refreshed every year from the Penguin Random House list of new titles and their back catalogue. It includes new authors and classic tales, fiction and non-fiction, diverse topics, characters and styles to reflect themes that are familiar to children as well as those that expand their imaginations. We're reminded of the impact of these amazing books every single day. We and Dolly and all of our partners working in the five countries where we have the Imagination Library receive letters, messages and calls pretty much every day from parents, from family members, from children themselves. And sometimes those children who received the books as children are now grown-ups and have children of their own. And they tell us about the joy that this programme and these books bring, the impact that they've had on relationships, on memories being created within families, and also the impact on children's language and literacy development. If we needed any reminder of why we do what we do, these messages give us just that. And Stevie mentioned that I was going to be telling you about an exciting launch of a new documentary about Dolly Parton's Imagination Library. And the place that it has in Dolly's life. It's called The Library That Dolly Built, and due to COVID restrictions, it's been premiered on Facebook. Initially in the USA on the 9th of December, but 7 p.m. in the USA is midnight here. So the decision's been made to have a launch on the following evening for the UK and Ireland. And that Facebook launch will happen on the 10th of December at 7 p.m. So if you log on to the Imagination Library Facebook page that day, you'll be able to see the documentary. There's also a Q&A session with Dolly, and Dolly will sing a song at the end, and we have a special guest who'll introduce that documentary for us for UK and Ireland. And it's really a celebration of all of the partnerships that make this international a programme, the international programme that's delivered locally and is embraced by communities large and small, and it's full of stories about those communities. So I'll end there and pass you back to Stevie, and I'll be happy to answer any questions shortly in the question and answer session that's coming up. Thank you.
Thanks a million, Marion. We're just back. I'm just going to go through a little bit of the chat here. That was brilliant, by the way, Marion. I appreciate it. And we will have a panel later with Marion and all of the other speakers, Catherine and Grace, who I'll introduce in a while. But there are tons of messages coming in. We're not going to be able to get around to them all, but I'll just read out a couple there for a couple of seconds. Hi to Christine. Well done to you. Young Knocknaheeny, brilliant initiative from Chris Kennedy, Mahon Family Resource Centre. Thank you, Marion, for a great overview. That's coming in from Tracy. You can never get enough books in the hands of young children. It's something the interagency group feel passionate about. I agree with that myself. Looking forward to the Library that Dolly Built documentary. Congratulations to everybody involved in the amazing initiative. That's coming in from Eilish Moynihan. Also, Ashling Williams, well done to all. It's a great initiative. There's loads of messages. I won't be able to get around to them all. I'll just read out a couple more. The Rotary Club of Cork are represented from Eugene. A wonderful initiative and presentation. Best wishes. Congratulations to Young Knocknaheeny from you, Duggan, as well. Dugan, from all your colleagues at the Genesis Programme in Louth. And from Lana, well done, Grace, and all in Young Knocknaheeny. It's actually bowling down here outside. I hope you can't hear all the rain. Yeah, we are going to have a panel, so keep any questions coming in. I've got some shout-outs to some of the youngsters who are going to be joining us as well. Hi as well to Young Ballymun and Carrigtool FRC. But we've got some video messages, as promised. A couple of batches of video messages from some Cork prominent figures, including Louise O'Neill, the author, Aoife O'Shea from Nibble and Twist, the HSE Happy Talk, and Alan Bennett, a Cork City football legend, who actually retired from football, a former Irish star as well. He only retired this week. So there's some video messages. Without further ado, let's leave these roll, and we'll come back in a few moments, and we're going to chat to Grace.
My name is Louise O'Neill, and I am genuinely thrilled to hear that Dolly Parton's Imagination Library is coming to Cork. Firstly, I'm just a huge fan of Dolly Parton. I mean, who isn't? And secondly, I just think this is an incredible initiative. You know, it's such a great way of ensuring that every child will have access to books and to stories and to all of the magical worlds that are contained within. I know that when I was a child, my mother used to bring me and my sister to our local library in Clonakilty every Saturday, and we used to get to choose our three books. I went through a phase of really being obsessed with Sweet Valley High, which my mother thought were, you know, just was complete trash. So she would let me take out two Sweet Valley High books, but then I had to take out like a classic as my third book. So, you know, like The Secret Garden or A Little Princess. And, you know, it's some of my happiest memories, just sitting there in the library and feeling completely transported to worlds and cultures and people that were so completely unlike my own. And I think that it really fostered my sense of creativity and imagination. And I really don't think that I would be a writer today if it wasn't for my local library, and if it wasn't for, I suppose, that access that I had to those books. And I am just so excited that the children who are going to be involved in the Dolly Parton Imagination Library will also be given that access, and I cannot wait to see what comes of it.
Hi, Alan Bennett here from Cork City FC. I'm delighted to be here today introducing Dolly Parton's Imagination Library Cork. It's such an incredible initiative. It's to support and encourage love of reading in early childhood in the home. Look, a load of studies have shown that children who are read to at an early life are better prepared for school and will support their development throughout primary school, secondary school, and further in their learning journey. For my own self, I see it every day because I'm also a student athlete, but I'm also a student teacher. So I see it every day with students that I teach, that when their vocabulary is more rounded and when they have a greater understanding of words and the concept of words, that they find their journey through school a lot easier and it's a lot more comfortable for them. So the more a child is read to, absolutely directly correlates to the easier journey they have through school. The presence of books at home is just easy for the child. They just pick up a book, they start reading. It's just to help the development of the child through those early formative years, which is so important. It can also create that bond between fathers and their children, or family members, uncles. I have it myself with my nephews who are all book crazy. They love it. And as a generation, kids nowadays might be saying that they don't like to read as much, but actually as a generation, they're reading way more now than they did previously, because they're constantly on social media and they're constantly on the other mediums where they're doing lots of reading constantly. So don't let that be an excuse for them, because as a generation now, they're reading a lot more than children have ever done. Most importantly, this initiative provides books to young children at no cost to families. And at this tough time when many people are struggling, this will be a welcome gift to help not only the children, but the parents and caregivers to spend quality time together, while also giving the children the wonderful gift of literacy and imagination. And in terms of lifelong learning and being part of that, it's literally a gift now that you're given that will stand to this person for future generations. So it's an amazing thing to be able to give to somebody. At Cork CDFC, we're really proud to be part of this initiative, and we're really proud to support this initiative. So thanks so much. I really appreciate your time and listening to this message. Thank you.
He was happy to go home with so many books where he could do his favourite thing, reading. Thanks, Stephen, the librarian, and Red the Bird. The end. Oh, hello. I'm here in Happy Talk with Nibbles, and we are delighted to hear that Dolly Parton's Imagination Library is coming to Cork. Nibbles, we're so excited, because in Happy Talk, we love books. We love reading. We love going to the library. Oh my gosh, we even like writing our own books. We just love books. Oh, Nibbles is so excited. She's tickling her whiskers. We hear that some of the Happy Talkers that we know, the Happy Talkers in Mahon and Kinsale Road and Glancon, they'll be able to sign up to Dolly Parton's Imagination Library and get lots of books right up to the age of 5. Oh my gosh, it's so excited. Congratulations to everybody involved. We are just delighted to hear that this new initiative is starting in Cork. Thank you all so much. Next though, Nibbles, where is Twitch? Can you see him? Oh, there he is, doing his favorite thing, reading. Go on, Nibbles. Why don't you go and sit with him and do some reading together?
Big thanks to Alan, Louise, Aoife, and of course, big shout out to Nibbles and Twitch. Loads of messages coming in. Hi to Councillor Kieran McCarthy, doing some great work there as well. Stephen has a question. I'll put some questions to the panellists later. We have a Q&A panel, and we will look at some of the messages in the chat as well. Loads of congratulations coming in. Impossible to keep up with them all. Without further ado, we're going to introduce Grace Walsh, Senior Oral Language Development Officer, Speech and Language Therapist, Young Knocknaheeny. She's going to present on bringing the Imagination Library to Cork. So congratulations, Grace. Take it away.
Thanks a million, Stevie. I'm here in the background trying to follow Marion's lead and share my slides as seamlessly as she did. So hopefully I'm up and running and everybody can see my slides. I'm absolutely delighted that our launch day has finally arrived for Dolly Parton's Imagination Library Cork. It's been a labour of love for all of us involved, and we're so excited that we can share it with you all today. And thank you for joining us. As Catherine and Marion mentioned, our story in Cork, and I suppose our journey here in Cork, started when we were inspired by our colleagues in the Childhood Development Initiative in TALA, who launched back in February 2019. And as Marion mentioned, some of the figures since, in terms of the numbers of books that have been gifted through the programme, are just incredible. Almost 90,000 books have been gifted on a monthly basis to children living in TALA for free through the programme. And what an amazing book. So we decided, you know, how can we bring this down to the real capital? And I do have to mention, I know that our Dublin colleagues are joining us today. We had a great weekend of sporting success here down in Cork at the weekend. So just to let you know, we have our eyes on Sam Maguire now this year, and our Cork City soccer women's team also have their eye on a cup next month. But we'll keep our rivalries on the pitch. And I'm happy to say that it has been very much an inter-county Cork and Dublin partnership. Thank you so much again to the support that you have given us in CDI to enable us to get to where we are today as a Cork affiliate in our own right. Young Knocknaheeny invited anybody across the city and county who would be interested in finding out more about how CDI brought the Imagination Library to TALA, and Emma Riley very kindly came down and visited us in June of last year for an exploratory meeting. And Emma convinced us straight away. We didn't take much convincing. I think anyone who learns of the programme really wants to find out, how can I get this initiative into my community? So right there and then in June, we established our local interagency working group. And I suppose initially we were tasked with raising funds to allow us to launch this programme. We're very lucky. We have sponsorship from OnPost, who sponsor the delivery costs of the books to all of the children in the home in Cork, similarly to the sponsorship that they provide in TALA. So that's an incredible sponsorship, and we're so appreciative to OnPost for this. And this month we have officially become a Cork affiliate of the Imagination Library, just in time for our launch. You'll see there's a picture there of us. That's a picture from June 2019 at that very first meeting where we met Dolly in a way for the very first time. And she looks very much at home next to Stevie there. So I think we're going to have some trouble trying to get Dolly back up to Knocknaheeny after today. Where can you register in Cork? So our initial geography for the Imagination Library in Cork includes Knocknaheeny, Holly Hill, Grána Brothair, Churchfield, Mahon, Carrigtuil, Ashburn House, and Kinsale Road Accommodation Centre. So if you have an address in any of these areas across the city and county, and you have a child or children aged from 0 to 5, you can register from today. How does it work? So through the Dollywood Foundation, we have access to their book ordering system technology. This means that once we receive a paper registration from parents and caregivers for their children, we can connect in with the registration system, or connect the registration system into the publisher's ordering system and the fulfillment agencies, which allow each book to be packaged and delivered into the homes of each child who's registered on a monthly basis. We also get access to the low cost price of approximately €1.36 per book per child per month, because of the fact that the foundation buys their books in bulk directly from the publishers. And as Marion mentioned, we get access to the Book Selection Committee, who meet every year to choose new, developmentally appropriate, culturally diverse, and I suppose most importantly, fun and exciting book titles to share with our children each month. The two core costs that aren't provided by the foundation are the individual cost price per book and the delivery costs. That means that as the local affiliate, and along with our interagency working group, we have to fundraise and seek sponsorship to cover these costs. There are approximately 2,700 children, so just under 3,000 children, who are eligible to register aged between 0 to 5, living in our current Cork pilot geography areas. That means that we need to budget for a book per child per month and it comes to a grand total of 44,000 euros to fund the initiative for this population for 1 year. The staff costs, so my own costs in terms of coordinating, and the costs of my colleagues on the Interagency Working Group, we, all of our costs are provided via our agencies. So every single cent raised goes directly towards buying books for children. And what's wonderful is our local Cork funds and Irish sponsorship stays local and goes directly through the post box into the books, go into the hearts and hands of our local children living in Cork. And as Marion and Catherine mentioned, please get in touch if you'd like to lend some sponsoring or some funding, or if you'd like to be a part of our working group. We'd love to hear from you. And this is just, I think, a lovely visual representation of, you know, what really is a community of partnerships working together with a common goal that has enabled us to bring the Imagination Library to life. So we've got the community, voluntary, statutory sectors, private organisations represented. So again, it just really shows that community spirit that's working in the background to bring it to life. Very importantly, how can you register? So if you're living in the catchment area and you have smallies under five, if you have, say, for example, if you've got three children under five, each child gets registered individually. So each child is going to get their very own book every month through the post. And the books will be different depending on the age and the stage of your child. So you'll have three different books coming through the post box every month. You can fill in a very easy, very simple registration form. We're just looking for your name, date of birth, address, and your signature that you're happy for us to pass on your details to our book ordering system. My email here is shared on screen, and I know that Tracy is doing a great job circulating information on the chat. And we've got four core coordinators because of the spread of geography of our area. So I'm covering the Young Knocknaheeny catchment area. Mary Carey is your link person in Carrigtwohill. Joni Barron is your link in the direct provision centres. And Linda McKernan is your Mahon link. So they might share their contact details in the chat. And if in doubt, get in touch with me and I'll connect you in with your local coordinator. When you sign up, there is an initial 6 to 8 week waiting period before you'll receive your first book. It just takes a little bit of time to connect you into the system. So if you register with us before the 1st of December, your smallies will receive their books in the post in January. But don't worry, if you don't register until December, you'll be receiving your books in February. And once you receive your books for the very first time, every month after that, you'll receive your books automatically. It's a one-off registration. So every child, so there's, I mentioned that every child gets a different book depending on their age. That's with the exception of the very first and the very last book. So every child in Cork who registers will receive the very same welcome book, which is The Little Engine That Could by Watty Piper. And we're very excited that Dolly is going to be reading us this book at the end of the launch today. And everyone gets a special letter from Dolly included in their first book. And the last book, so as children graduate from the program at age five, they're going to receive The Selfish Giant by Oscar Wilde. There's been such lovely sentiments shared, and we've a few more to come in some other videos about really the power and the magic that books and exposure to reading can offer young children. And I'm going to leave you with Dr. Seuss's sentiments. The more that you read, the more things you will know, the more that you learn, the more places you'll go. Thank you so much. We're so excited to be launching today, and thanks for all of your support, and looking forward to chatting and linking in with you more later on. Thanks, Stevie.
Thanks a million, Grace. We are going to be talking to all the panelists in just a few moments. There's some questions coming in. There's loads of shout outs coming in. We'll get around to them all. We've got a few more messages from prominent Cork people or people living here in Cork, including authors Judy Curtin, Sarah Murphy, education advocate David Putman as well. So without further ado, we're going to leave these roll and we'll come back with all of the panelists for a little chat in just a few moments.
Hi there, my name is Judy Curtin, and I'd like to say how very happy I am that Dolly Parton's Imagination Library has arrived in Cork. Books for children are so important, and the idea that so many young children will get books over the first few years of their lives, well, to me, that's really a wonderful thing. When I was a little girl, my family moved around a lot, and that could be exciting at times, but sometimes it was difficult, getting used to new schools, new faces, new friends, and living in strange new places. And during those times, books were a great support to me. When times were not so great, it was really nice to curl up with an old familiar book or maybe a new book and forget about my surroundings and be taken to a whole new world. I haven't got many toys left from my childhood, but books, some of the books I had that were so precious to me that I will never ever part with them. So old fashioned books like Little Women, Heidi was a particular favourite of mine, and of course books by Enid Blyton, one here that doesn't even have a proper cover anymore, but these were so special to me. And I have a great career now as a writer, and I would not have that if it weren't for all the books I had when I was a little girl. So all I want to do is say how amazing you people are who have set all of this up. It's a wonderful, wonderful initiative, and I'm sure it's going to be a huge success. Well done. Thanks.
Hi, my name is Sarah Murphy. I'm a children's author based in Cork, and I've written two children's books called What If and More What If. I'm so delighted to be taking part in this Dolly Parton Imagination Library Cork initiative. It's just a wonderful way for children to magically receive books through the post from time to time, and a wonderful opportunity for parents to bond with children over books. When you open up a book, you open up a world of magic. It's sort of like eating ice cream on a hot day or drinking hot chocolate on a cold day. It's a world full of excitement and adventure. Now, when I was younger, there was a library close to me, but I never availed of it. And it's only now that I'm older that I'm really reading quite a bit. But children will come to books in their own way, in their own time. And if you nurture this love of books, they will take off. My wish for children is that they would dip into different types of books, some with more words than pictures, some with more pictures than words. And when they do this over time, they will strike gold, and they will find that book that will be for them their secret treasure for the rest of their life. Enjoy the journey. Thank you.
Hello, I'm David Putnam, and for many, many years I was a film producer. Now I teach at a number of universities, including University of Cork, UCC. I was an avid reader as a young person. In fact, so much so, but my mother used to get quite cross with me because she'd be calling me for tea, and I literally would block out every single other aspect. And she'd actually have to come across and shake me out of my book and go and have my tea. So books have always been very important to me. The whole issue of reading has been important to me. I started with Pinocchio, partly because I saw Pinocchio as a movie, and comparing the movie with the book was a big deal. I subsequently did it with Great Expectations and other fantastic books. But anyone can get hold of any book and immerse themselves in it. The way it leaves you with memories and thoughts and things to consider is quite extraordinary. So please, 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 anyone can do anything to help young people get hold of books, to read to them, is doing that young person a lifetime favor.
Thanks a million for all of the messages from all of the different people today, inspiring stuff. And there's loads of questions coming in, which I'm going to put to the panel now. Actually, from my own perspective, we are involved in a bit of work at the moment for Douglas Week in Cork. And Frederick Douglass, who I'm not sure everyone knows, will hopefully be more known around Cork after it. This is happening in February. And it's a big cross-collaboration thing. And as a former slave himself who escaped slavery and helped the abolition process and who came to Cork, it inspired him. I think education and books was everything, because we take so much for granted, but these guys weren't allowed to read. And it was only he really empowered himself through reading, and he got the knowledge to feel that like he wasn't inferior, even stuff that we all take for granted. As a youngster, when he was reading pretty much illegally, he eventually escaped slavery and ended up changing things for the better. So Douglas Week is happening in Cork soon, celebrating that. But I think it ties in to loads of of what we've been discussing today about knowledge being so important. And it's good to have the accessibility. Lots of people are talking about direct provision. We have some questions about it, actually. And one of the really good questions I thought, which I'm going to put to the panel now, are all the books in English only? So if any of you want to talk about that one or answer that one, Grace, Catherine, if any of you want to jump in there, Marion as well. That was one of the questions which I thought was pretty relevant. Are all the books in English only? So whenever you're ready, guys.
That's a great question. Yeah. Marion, yeah, unfortunately, I think the answer is yes, that they are currently in English only. But I think it's something that we could certainly work towards going forward in terms of having a book in Irish.
Absolutely. You know, I mean, anything's possible. One of the things that we are very, very careful to do is to try to keep the costs at an absolute minimum. And sadly, to translate a relatively small number of books into more than one language is expensive to do. However, if we are, you know, if we have enough programmes and enough children being enrolled in those programmes across the whole of Ireland at some stage, then we would be, you know, in a different position and we could maybe have that conversation again at that point. But for now, I'm afraid they're only in English.
Okay. And just to add, Stevie, as well, let's not let this be a barrier to enjoying books, you know. These are picture books. They're also about babies' experiences with books and young children, you know, if they're touching them, feeling them, opening them, pointing at them, creating their own stories out of the books, connecting with them in their own ways. Like this, you know, that's what we really want. It's just the experience of books from that really young age. So I think this is a really important starting point. And wouldn't it be lovely to have it in different languages? And the Irish language is great as read, but we've got something to kind of inspire the experience of books from very early life. And you know, we're partnering with our libraries as well. So we're just building up those resources so that people can then go off and find their own books and have their own experience of books themselves. I think that's just important to acknowledge as well.
Exactly, and it's amazing what you've been doing so far. I mean, you've gone through the process in detail of how I mean, the amount of steps that have to be taken. And now we are living in a country where people, like, I can only speak English, which is to my embarrassment. But now we live in a country where lots of the young kids can even speak multiple languages. So going forward, this is great. But as loads of people have pointed out, and you pointed out yourself, the picture books and just getting people a taste, you know what I mean? One of the other good questions I thought we're going to have to probably rush it along because we're going to be having to go to Dolly in a second was lots of the more technical ones which we can get to directly, and I think they've been answered since, but someone was saying, and I think Marion showed some slides of people choosing the books, how are the books chosen for children, and are there Irish authors in the library? I think some of them have been answered, but do you want to take that one, Marion?
Yes, absolutely. So once a year, our book selection committee meets usually in the Penguin Random House offices in London. This year, we had an online book selection committee meeting, and they review the books that are currently in the programme, and we ask for feedback on the books that are in the programme. That feedback's taken into account. So sometimes a book that's popular will stay in for 2 or maybe 3 years. If we don't get such good feedback about it, we might take it out after a year. So the book selection list is refreshed every single year. And, you know, the considerations are around, would this book be accessible to families where the parents' language, first language wasn't English? Or, you know, does the range of books that we select reflect the range of different families and situations that children might be familiar with? So a great deal of care goes into selecting the books, and they all are selected to be age appropriate for each child who receives a book through the programme.
Okay, terrific stuff. And I gotta say, as someone who works with people in direct provision and myself, it's absolutely brilliant that these areas are being dealt with here and stuff. And accessibility is everything. Look, I'm only going to go to one more question because lots of them are technical. There's some brilliant shout outs. I might do one or two of them at the end. But one final question from Suzanne Rigby. Are there any tips to share to those parents who struggle with literacy in sharing the books with their children?
Yeah, absolutely. I suppose the most important thing is, you know, the book is almost like a vehicle. It's that, you know, you can cuddle up together and use the book however you can yourself. So you might just want to, you know, if you have your own literacy difficulties, have a chat about the pictures, you know, follow your child's lead. They might want to just look at the back of the book, and that's okay too. And maybe if you have a young baby, they're more interested in having a bit of a chew off of the books. So you can kind of just do whatever works for you guys, share and explore the book and have fun with the book in whatever way suits. And, you know, if language and literacy is a difficulty, maybe chat around the pictures or use the book to start telling your own story.
Okay, terrific stuff. Big thanks to Marion, Grace and Catherine. You're doing amazing stuff. My new bestie has got a message which we're going to sign out with. I'll have some closing remarks and we might do a couple of more hellos at the end, because I know there's a couple of young schools that I want to say hello to as well. But Dolly Parton is going to read a little clip from The Engine, The Little Engine That Could, by Watty Piper, which is the welcome book for children in Cork who register with the programme. Regarding some of the other questions, we have logged them and they will be dealt with. We'll try to send on the messages because there's some technical questions. But Dolly, it's up to you now to take it away.
Hello, I'm Dolly Parton, the book lady from the Imagination Library, and I'm going to be reading a very special book today. This is called The Little Engine That Could. This book is so special. It's its 90th anniversary. It was written by Watty Piper and illustrated by Dan Santat. Are you ready to read this special book? Well, here I go. Chug, 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 puff. Puff, puff, ding, dong, ding, dong. The little train rumbled over the tracks. She was a happy little train, for she had such a jolly load to carry. Her cars were filled full of good things for boys and girls. There were toy animals, giraffes with long necks, teddy bears with almost no necks at all, and even a baby elephant. Then there were dolls. Dolls with blue eyes and yellow curls, dolls with brown eyes and brown bobbed heads, and the funniest little toy clown you ever saw. And there were cars full of toy engines, airplanes, tops, jackknives, picture puzzles, books, and every kind of thing boys or girls could want. But that was not all. Some of the cars were filled with all sorts of good things for boys and girls to eat. Big golden oranges, red-cheeked apples, bottles of creamy milk for their breakfasts, fresh spinach for their dinners, peppermint drops, and lollipops for after-meal treats. The little train was carrying all these wonderful things to the good little boys and girls on the other side of the mountain. She puffed along merrily, then all of a sudden, she stopped with a jerk. She simply could not go another inch. She tried and she tried, but her wheels would not turn. What were all those good little boys and girls on the other side of the mountain going to do without the wonderful toys to play with and the good food to eat? Here comes a shiny new engine, said the funny little clown who jumped out of the train. Let us ask him to help us. So all the dolls and toys cried out together, please, shiny new engine, won't you please pull our train over the mountain? Our engine has broken down, and the boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us. But the shiny new engine snorted, I pull you? I am a passenger engine. I have just carried a fine big train over the mountain with more cars than you ever dreamed of. My train has sleeping cars with comfortable berths, a dining car where waiters bring whatever hungry people want to eat, and parlor cars in which people sit in soft armchairs and look out of big plate glass windows. I pull the likes of you? Indeed not. And off he steamed to the roundhouse where engines live when they're not busy. How sad the little train, all the dolls and toys felt. Then the little clown called out, "The passenger engine is not the only one in the world. Here is another engine coming, a great big strong one. Let us ask him to help us." The little toy clown waved his flag and the big strong engine came to a stop. "Please, oh please, big engine," cried all the dolls and toys together. "Won't you please pull our train over the mountain? Our engine has broken down and the good little boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us." But the big strong engine bellowed, "I am a freight train. I've just pulled a big train loaded with big machines over the mountain. These machines print books and newspapers for grown-ups to read. I'm a very important engine indeed. I won't pull the likes of you." And the freight train puffed off indignantly to the roundhouse. The little train and all the dolls and toys were very sad. "Cheer up," cried the little toy clown. "The freight engine is not the only one in the world. Here comes another. He looks very old and tired, but our train is so little, perhaps he can help us." So the little toy clown waved his flag and the dingy, rusty old engine stopped. "Please, kind engine," cried all the dolls and toys together. "Won't you please pull our train over the mountain? Our engine has broken down, and the boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us." But the rusty old engine sighed, "I'm too tired. I must rest my weary wheels. I cannot pull even so little a train as yours over the mountain. I cannot, I cannot, I cannot." And off he rumbled to the roundhouse chugging, "I cannot, I cannot, I cannot." Then, indeed, the little train was very, very sad, and the dolls and toys were ready to cry. But the little clown called out, "Here is another engine coming, a little blue engine, a very little one. Maybe she'll help us." The very little engine came chug, chug, chugging merrily along. When she saw the toy clown's flag, she stopped quickly. "What is the matter, my friends?" she asked kindly. "Oh, little blue engine," cried the dolls and toys, "will you pull us over the mountain? Our engine has broken down, and the good boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us. Please help us, little blue engine." "I'm not very big," said the little blue engine. "They use me only for switching trains in the yard. I've never been over the mountain." "But we must get over the mountain before the children are awake," said all the dolls and toys. The very little engine looked up and saw the tears in the doll's eyes, and she thought of the good little boys and girls on the other side of the mountain who would not have any toys or good food unless she helped. Then she said, "I think I can, I think I can, I think I can." And she hitched herself to the little train. She tugged and pulled and tugged, and slowly, slowly, they started off. The toy clown jumped aboard and all the dolls and toy animals began to smile and cheer. Puff, puff, chug, chug, went the little blue engine. "I think I can, I 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 think I can." Up, 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 faster and faster and faster the little engine climbed until at last they reached the top of the mountain. Down in the valley lay the city. Hooray, hooray, cried the funny little clown and all the dolls and toys. The good little boys and girls in the city will be happy because you helped us, kind little blue engine. And the little blue engine smiled and seemed to say, as she puffed steadily down the mountain, I thought I could, 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 I thought I could. Isn't that fun? I even wrote a song about this little book. It goes, whoa, 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 whoa. I can do it, so can you. Whoa, 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 whoa. I believe in you, and I do too. Good night.
Well, 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 thanks a million to Dolly. There's so many shout outs coming in. Just want to say a quick hi to the gang in Junior Infants in St. Mary's in the Hale School, Miss Murphy's, Miss Horgan's classes. Also, Skull Potter Pio, they sent in a message yesterday. They were ahead of the game. Mahon Community Preschool are very excited. There's so many messages coming in. But myself and Dolly are going back up to Knocknaheeny. We're thinking of going to the cabin and recording a little track later with GMC just across the road from Young Knocknaheeny. But I'd like to thank all of the panelists once again for all of the information and all of the passionate work you've been doing. Grace Walsh, Marion Gilhooly, I hope I didn't mispronounce your name, and Catherine as well, and all of you guys for all of the messages. Some of the questions will be answered directly after. I know Tracy has logged some of the questions, so thanks to Tracy. Thanks to VE Studio for hosting it, Thomas putting it all together smoothly, and all of the messages of support from various Cork-based supporters of the project. But thanks once again and have a great day, and thanks for joining us today for the launch of Dolly Parton's Imagination Library. And yeah, that's it for me. Bye.
Talk with you. My-